Noaia, welcome to Tagata Pasifika.
Noaia e Māori, tēne ngā ngāj atakoa on the show today. Keeping the roof over your head in tough times, we meet the group that's doing just that.
Cost of living is really make it very hard for our people. It's hard to make ends meet and put food on the table.
Another crop of potential media workers sign up for the Te Rito internship program.
All of them bring their cultural aspects to the industry, and that's their point of difference.
And a new book sheds light on the Pacific experience at the height of the COVID lockdown.
We're trying to invite as many people as possible to write, so you're not carrying it all internally.
Foyaksia. But first to health, where a national report on breast cancer screening says about 50,000 women missed out on screening in the past 2 years because of COVID disruptions. The highly critical report also says a high number of Pacific and Māori women most likely were affected, and it makes 26 recommendations for change. In response, Te Whatuora has announced a new national screening register and a breast screening action plan.
And still with health, a special Rally Your Village Community Matters campaign is underway at the Pacific Hub in Ōtara to support South Auckland families prepare for winter with flu, COVID-19 and MMR immunisations. Now, the 12-week campaign is a collaboration between the South Seas Healthcare Trust and the local community, and it includes activation events with food, music, giveaways and trips to the rugby. Two events have already been run, and the next one begins on May 15. The community's encouraged to sign up, get a care plan, immunisations and event tickets to the next local Blues game.
Nice. To the region now, and Dalton Tangelangi has been re-elected Premier of Niue for a second term. Long-serving Niue MP Olof Jacobson is the Deputy Premier and is one of four women members of Niue's Assembly, the most in the country's history. Tangelangi is expected to announce his cabinet when the 18th Niue Whonoe Ke Pule opens next week. And still in the Pacific, US President Joe Biden will make a short visit to Papua New Guinea later this month. The president's expected to make a three-hour stop to meet PNG Prime Minister James Marape and other foreign leaders. It's a follow-up to the first-ever US Pacific Islands Summit held in Washington last year.
And finally, today is Rotuma Day, which wraps up Rotuman Language Week here in Aotearoa. Now, the theme is, now, John, I know you're fluent now.
Thank you, Foyaksia. And the theme for Ngasavne Whaianga Rotuamta is Vetokia o Sveinga Maeng Whekhenua.
Very impressive, which means sustaining our language and culture. Now, the community around the country have been commemorating their identity at schools, communities and events on the catwalk even. Rotuman fashion designer Michael Mausior showcased his designs, House of Mausior, infusing the rich culture and traditional art form of the Pacific. Nice. And infusing these ancient works of art into each garment. Incredible. Yeah. And John, that would make a nice Mother's Day present, I think.
Thank you. I'm too excelled if you're going to buy me a dress. All right, to our first story now, and the cost of living crisis continues to make life challenging for our Pasifika communities, with many struggling to make ends meet.
That is so right. That has been doubly difficult for Pacific homeowners, many of whom are at risk of losing their homes due to mortgage arrears, as Anaoli Karima Whai'ai reports.
Good morning.
Hello, how are you?
Oh, good, good.
How are this you place doing? Is more than just a house for Potase Ikiwa. This is home.
It's sentimental. That's the word I'd say. Good family house, yeah. We've been here at least 34 years.
But it almost came to an end when she was laid off work due to COVID and she fell behind on her mortgage payments.
It was really hard, it was stressful. It's a headache. My family did help me, but they can only help me so much because I know, I understand they have families themselves.
Ultimately, she was issued a Property Law Act notice, which meant she was at risk of losing her home.
Becoming homeless, yes. Yeah. It was scary, but, you know, I just thought, oh, no, I couldn't do that to myself, you know. My mortgage.
Vi Harris from the Viola Budgeting Service in Mangere says Potasi is just one of many Pasifika homeowners on the brink of losing their homes.
because some of our people have too many debts, too many loans, also should be living in income and wages they're getting benefit, but they live beyond their means.
The current cost of living crisis has compounded their struggles, with some turning to quick fix solutions such as gambling.
The cost of living is really make it very hard for our people. Power and also rights, which is increasing, make it Pacific Island people, it's hard to make ends meet and put food on the table.
Which is why Viola have been getting their clients back on track by helping them with budgeting and paying off their debts.
The costing of living is crazy. She helped me with a lot of phone calls, with the bank, using my KiwiSaver in order to save my house.
It's our job to give them a planner, teach them how to manage their money, teach them what to spend and what to pay.
Vi says food buying habits have also got to change.
Stop buying food every day because some of our people, they take away 5 days, 6 days, pay to cook food, much, much healthier. You heard from Porikopi?
Financial commitments to family and Donga is what made this owner of two properties fall behind on her mortgage payments. So she turned to Viola for help.
Sometimes I thought to myself, I'll leave the mortgage for next week. And when I get to this, I'm falling in behind with my payment. I thought to myself, I better listen to the budgeter and put my mortgage payment first. Because it's quite good to have your own home.
If you got no money and you own a house, you are really rich.
Yeah, that's right.
Right now, Potasi is staying afloat. And most importantly, she still has her home.
I wouldn't like to go down that road again. I'm losing my house. So I'd rather just stay on top of things now.
She's encouraging others not to shy away from seeking help.
I was shy to ask for help, but I had to, you know? Because if I wasn't for that, where am I going to turn to? If you get yourself into situations like this, it's good to try and get yourself help.
Now, if you would like to get in touch with Viola Pacific Islands Budgeting Services, you can head to their website at viola.org.
Well, stay with us after the break. Where to now? Following last week's community meeting with the Immigration Minister, we find out in our Talanoa. And later, the new book shedding light on the Pasifika COVID experience.
Words are so powerful. And so if we internalise them, they can suffocate us. I really believe that. That's why we're trying to invite as many people as possible to write.
New homebound.
Noaia, welcome back. Well, last week, Immigration Minister Michael Wood met with members of the Pacific community in an At Times fiery meeting discussing the allegations of a dawn raid in Auckland nearly a month ago. While the ministers put things on hold pending a review, the meeting raised other issues around immigration and overstayers. Here to give his take on related matters is Pakilau o Aotearoa Manase Lua from the Aotearoa Tongan Response Group. Malo Elele, thank you very much for joining us on the program, Pakilau.
Malo Elele, marama noia.
First of all, when you heard there had been a dawn raid last month within our own Pacific community, what did you think?
Absolutely disgusted. You know, it's so soon after the apology, and to have 19 people dawn raided, people of colour, and many of the Mao people, it was just totally heartbreaking to hear.
Now, I know that you were involved with the community meeting that was held a week ago with the Minister of Immigration. How did you feel that meeting went?
I think the meeting served its purpose, which was to bring the minister and his officials to the meeting. It was great to have six other Pacific MPs there, well attended. We also brought our people from the communities, even people who were overstaying, to the meeting to be heard. We even had an overstayer state the case. I think our voices were loud and clear. Now we want action. So there's a lot of apologising going on, a lot of talk, but we've had enough of the talk. We want action.
Now, part of the response to that was that all dawn raids or out-of-hours visits would be halted, they'd be stopped in the meantime, pending a review. What did you think about that?
It's a good start, I guess. It falls short of actually having an amnesty or a pathway to residency for overstayers so that they're not in that position anymore. However, to have the minister and the officials say they're not going to dawn raid anyone until they finish the review is something, but still it doesn't go far enough, and we want this sorted before the election.
It was 3 years ago this month that you presented a big petition to government about this amnesty. Since then, nothing has happened.
Yeah, I mean, we've followed up with a submission in 2021 after we put in a 35,000 signature petition to Parliament. We also followed up with requests and letters to the government and the officials, and there's been nothing.
What have you heard, though? Has there been any kind of talk about how close this could be to it happening, or
sure,
how open they are to it?
What we hear is that they're looking at it. That's their key phrase. We're looking at it, we're inquiring, we're doing more research. But 3 years is a long time, Marama, and I'm surely they can sort it out.
And I'm sure it's getting closer to the election. You don't want this to be really an election issue itself, though.
No, we don't want it to become a bargaining chip for our Pasifika votes and for our Asian vote. They should make a decision now. They had the chance at the dawn raid apology to make this an announcement and to make something wrong right, but they didn't do that.
Now, we've had amnesties before. Why is it so important, do you think, for our overstayers to have something now, especially in light of COVID? We've got a lot of a need for workers right now in New Zealand.
We don't condone overstaying, but it happens. And some people were actually stuck here during the lockdown, so they had no opportunity to extend their visas or for whatever reason. Also, the children of overstayers, they're a very innocent party in this.
How many children do you think there are?
From some figures I've heard, 500, and they're stateless children. Mm. So these are children that are at school. Some of them don't even know they're overstayers until they've left school and try to get into university, realise they're not actually citizens or have permanent residency. Imagine the shame and the psychological impacts that has.
Okay, so your message to government, to all political parties, that this is something that our Pacific community would like to see, an amnesty not just for Pacific people who are overstayers?
We did the petition for all 14,000 overstayers. That includes the Chinese, the Indian community. In fact, the highest number of dawn raided people in this last year were Chinese, 10 Chinese and Indians. And that's 19 too many, and all people of colour. So the dawn raids are still race-based. They need to stop now. and we need to make changes and change the system so we don't have the need for dawn raids or overstaying. The system needs to change.
And what else are you doing about this? I understand you've got a protest today even.
We do have a protest today, a peaceful assembly at the Minister of Immigration's office in Dominion Road. We'll be there with the Migrants Association, with Anu Kaloti and her team, and some of our Pacific people will be there in support and in solidarity this afternoon at 1 o'clock.
Malo apito, pakilaho Aotearoa. Thank you very much for coming on the program today.
Thank you, Marama. Malo.
Payaksia, well, after the break, Koviki tears, the book. But next, the new crop of potential Pasifika media workers.
We want to aspire to people coming into leadership positions and making a real difference at all levels of the industry.
Noaia e Māori, welcome back to Tagata Pasifika, a program aimed at making sure newsrooms reflect a multicultural Aotearoa is key to the Te Rito Journalism Project, now in its second year.
It's a cadet program and it's offered to Māori, Pasifika and diverse groups to get a taste of the media industry. Reporter Gladys Hartson went along to meet some of the new recruits for this story.
It's never too late to learn for mature student Alu Alu Moana Lakeisha Luaitalo.
So is it Malo Elele?
The mother of five is back in the classroom after years working in the corporate world, and she's picking up skills.
Being of Samoan Chinese descent, I feel like we're so underrepresented out there, and we need someone like me to go out and tell these stories.
Alu Alu Moana is part of the latest intake of the Te Rito Journalism Project. Designed to encourage more Māori and Pasifika and diverse peoples to tell our stories in the media.
We've got 12 candidates this year. Really excited about them. It's a really good mix of people, ages ranging between 18 and 40. We have a couple of mothers, you know, and they're going to bring their own experience for all of them. They'll bring their lived experience, their cultural aspects to journalism, to the industry, and that's their point of difference.
Proud of her Samoan and Chinese heritage, Alu Alu Moana is not alone on this journey. No stranger to media, having worked on the TV show Attitude and holding a degree in communications, William hopes to amplify the voices of the disabled community. And speaking of lifting the voices, Fijian Merewai Durutalo wants to tell the stories of her Pasifika community in Dunedin.
I feel there's still a lot of work to be done in that space, just hearing their stories and their talanoa, and also possibly have my perspective of being Polynesian and Melanesian. So that's kind of where I feel my drive is for pursuing this cadetship.
During the year, cadets will get to meet with Māori, Pasifika and mainstream journalists while getting vital hands-on experience.
Having Pacific people participate in the Te Rito program is incredibly important because of the total proportion of journalists in New Zealand, only 1.8% represent Pacific, and we know that that is disproportionate to the population of our Pacific people, which is therefore important to our representation and how we come across in media.
And with these new tools, the Te Rito cadets could be well on their way to becoming the next wave of journalists in Aotearoa.
I hope to finally be able to tell our stories from a Samoan perspective, in that our Samoan culture is, even though there's, you know, so much out there, there's more that needs to be said.
We want to aspire to people coming into leadership positions and making a real difference at all levels of the industry.
Oh, congratulations, guys, and good luck. Now, the lived experiences of some of our Pasifika and Indigenous peoples through the COVID lockdowns is the focus of a new book launched in Auckland recently.
It's called Our Kōwiki Tears, and as Alice Lolohea reports, it's a project which acknowledges and celebrates many first-time writers.
If I wake up tomorrow and I am still here, I would show gratitude first with a silent prayer. If I wake up tomorrow and I'm still here, I would kiss all my children and grandchildren dear.
Miliyama Tapusoa shared her poem, Tomorrow, a piece which details her experience of coming close to death.
So in April 2022, I tested positive for COVID. I was really not well. And because I've had lupus for such a long time, I actually know my body really well. So I said to my son, you need to take me to the hospital. When I got there, the female doctor, she just said to me, I know that you're a nurse, so I'm just gonna give it to you straight. And she said, it's not good.
Miliyama, alongside other writers, shared their pieces at the launch of Our Kōwiki Tears, love from our Indigenous queens and kings. It's the second literary offering from Indigenous Queens, or IQ Talanoa, and through this group, many of the contributors found a safe space to fully express themselves during the lockdown.
So Talanoa is a space where you can come, vent, cry, laugh, sing, dance about anything, and know that you'll be heard. So we scheduled writing periods online, and I said, just turn up, whether you're a writer or not, turn up and we'll make it fun.
The book is a raw, unfiltered look at life during the COVID-19 pandemic, a collection of stories and poems written during this time. For writer Christina Epati, the book launch was the first time she had revisited her work.
What is severe COVID? Is it similar to severe anxiety? Severe hardship? Severe love? Severe depression? Severe trauma? Breathe through a straw. Will it affect my unborn child?
My writings were about the experience that my whānau had during COVID. So we were one of the major whānau that was impacted by the outbreak in South Auckland.
Over 50 members of Christina's family were affected during the outbreak, and four people were hospitalised, including Christina's parents.
It was horrific to think that your parents contributed to New Zealand society since the 70s, and then to turn up to hospital in 2021 and there was no interpreters on site to support with language, and that's kind of what the basis of some of my writings was about.
Words are so powerful, and so if we internalise them, they can suffocate us. That's why we're trying to invite as many people as possible to write. Write out. You don't have to share it with us, but just to get it down so you're not carrying it all internally.
For contributor and librarian Leota Alice Meredith, she'd like to stock more of these books onto library shelves.
This project should be an ongoing awareness of in response to the fact that Pacific literature is needed by, and it's Pacific literature by Pacific people.
Congratulations, Faxia. Well, that's the end of our show. Remember, you can watch the stories again on tpplus.co.nz or TVNZ Plus.
And stay up to date with the latest news. Just go to our social media platforms. For now, have a great Mother's Day weekend, Aotearoa.
Hanisi off.
And happy Rotuman Day. La ma alalum.
People love the sons to our new homebound. Tagata Pasifika, born a people proud.